Good afternoon, fans, and welcome to Art Keller Field on the campus of Carthage College. The College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin and all of its members promote good sporting behavior by student athletes, coaches, and fans. We request your cooperation in supporting the student athletes and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, derogatory comments, or other intimidating actions directed at student athletes, officials, team representatives, or other fans will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. The CCIW has many traditions, but bad behavior isn't one of them. We appreciate your cooperation in creating a safe and positive game environment. Respect, it's the name of the game. If you need assistance or have any questions, please find a member of the Carthage College athletic staff located throughout the facility. Fans, a reminder, if the Firebirds score 15 goals in today's contest, you go home with free cheese curds courtesy of Culver's. And if the Firebird defense holds their opponent to 20 or fewer shots, you get one scoop of an ice cream sundae from Culver's. Be sure to cheer on the Firebirds all game for your chance to win free coupons courtesy of Culver's. At this time, Carthage Athletics would like to thank the following corporate sponsors: Pullman Motors, Satori Energy, Doctors of Physical Therapy, Haribo, Comprehensive Orthopedics, Nike, BSN Sports, Lee Mechanical, Riley Construction, Pepsi, Public Craft Brewing, Badger Bus, The Stella Hotel and Ballroom, Hampton Inn and Suites, Culver's, Chick-fil-A, Giordano's, and Jersey Mike's.
Driving at speed, I'm fire, I stay high on the TV. Art Keller Field here in Kenosha, Wisconsin. Psyched for today's NCAA Division III women's lacrosse matchup between the visiting Aurora University Spartans and the Carthage College Firebirds. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Justin Corrigan, taking you along for the ride as the Firebirds host the Spartans on this chilly Saturday just off the shores of Lake Michigan. Game time temperature is going to be about 34 degrees. As the 3-4 Spartans come in to take on the 4-2 Firebirds on a bright and sunny day. Wasn't sure the weather would be quite this nice heading in. Snow yesterday all throughout Kenosha. Got a couple inches on the ground. The Carthage staff did a wonderful job of clearing the field, and we are almost ready for action here. Once again, the Firebirds coming in 4-2 overall, 2-0 at home. The Spartans 3-4 overall, 1-2 on the road. Firebirds coming in off a 19-0 impressive win over MSOE, their second consecutive win following a road win over Concordia, Wisconsin, which finished 18-5 back on March 13th. Spartans coming in also on the heels of two wins, a tight 18-17 win over Wisconsin River Falls on March 16th, and a 15-10 win over Wisconsin Lacrosse on March 20th. A couple names to watch for here for the Spartans is going to be number 20, Brianna Peck, coming in with 21 goals, team leader. Not far behind her at 19 is Kenley Axvig. And then Danielle Cobbett, 14 goals as the top three scorers for the Spartans. And for the Firebirds side, the two names to watch for right now on the offensive end, Piper Lefevre. August Claridge tied for the team lead by a landslide with 22 goals each on the year. Lefevre just ahead in the point totals with 28, and she's also been credited with 6 assists compared to Claridge's 4.
Good afternoon, fans, and welcome to our Keller Field.
And before we get into more of the stats, let's take you down to the field for the intros.
Carthage College Firebirds. Let's meet today's starting lineups. First, for the visiting Spartans, at attack, number 2, Grace Peltier. At defense, number 5, Kylie Reeve. At attack, number 7, Daniel Koval. At defense, number 10, Taylor Jansen. At attack, number 11, Kaylee Russell. At midfield, number 13, Cassidy Fissner. At attack, number 18, Sid Mann. At defense, number 19, Caitlin Crone. At midfield, number 20, Kenley Axman. At mid, number 23, Brianna Peck. At midfield, number 33, Mackenzie Wilson. And in goal, number 42, Megan Ginty. The head coach of Aurora is Christina Free, and she is assisted by Kate Kuzmenko and Audrey Warner.
Yeah.
starting lineup for your Carthage College Firebirds. At attack number two, Shannon Heitschmidt. At attack number three, August Claridge. At defense number five, Hannah Kim. At midfield number seven, Sophia Winterkorn.
At midfield number eight, Kylie Higgins.
At defense number nine, Sydney Kuyama. At defense number 14, Kaylee Wagner. At attack number 15, Emma McDonald. At midfield number 16, Taylor Roth. At attack number 19, Piper LaFever. At defense number 22, Hannah Kohler. And in goal, scoring number 33, Alessandra Almendares. The head coach of Carthage is Rebecca Conjol, who is assisted by Rachel Harris and Izzy Rayle.
Well, there you have it, the starters for both sides. As Aurora and Carthage getting ready to battle here at Art Keller Field.
There will be no national anthem today. Thank you.
We get ready to roll here. A little bit of confusion over the national anthem. National anthem was already played for the Carthage men's lacrosse game against Hope, which took place earlier this afternoon. Firebirds fell to the Dutchmen. Now the Firebirds on the women's side looking to get the win over the Spartans and improve to 5-2. As mentioned before, the last two wins for the Firebirds have come against Concordia, Wisconsin, and MSOE. The wins before that came at home against Marion, Wisconsin in the opener on February 24th, a 9-3 finish. And a road victory at St. Mary's College, where the Firebirds took down the Bells 16-5. Two losses came on their trip to Denver, Colorado. Correction, Colorado Springs, Colorado. Firebirds fell in both of their matchups out there. First falling 20-6 to Ursinus College, and then 19-8 to Colorado College. Two tough matchups early in the season, and head coach Rebecca Conjol said she wanted tough matchups early to prepare for difficult matchups down the stretch, such as conference foe UChicago. Almost set here to start things off. Here at the starting draw. For Aurora, it will be Kenley Axvig, previously mentioned top three scorer for the Spartans. Be Piper LaFever, tied for leading score for the Firebirds. Almost set to roll here. Lead whistle goes. And possession begins for the Firebirds. The ground ball pickup for Kylie Higgins, the sophomore out of Algonquin, Illinois. On the far end, working around the back of the net. Higgins back with it. Finds Claridge. And back and forth they go. and setting up the offense. Lefevre makes a move on the inside. Pass. Not fielded cleanly. Ball on the ground. It appears the Spartans have retained possession. And after a whistle, it is going to be Spartans possession here early. Quick move into territory, and the pass goes awry. Aurora recovers. It's going to go out of bounds and be given to Carthage. Back the other way goes Claridge. Pass off target and recovered by the Spartans. They take it back the other way. Failed clear attempt for Carthage. Aurora very quickly moving down back into Carthage territory. Behind the net, trying to set up the offense. Pass inside. Cleanly shot. Score. Try and see who in the mix of that Spartan offense came away with the shot there.
And an Aurora goal by number 20, Kenley Axvig.
That is indeed Kenley Axvig, her 20th goal on the season. First one today. The Spartans jump out to a quick 1-0 lead here, 12:49 to go in the first. Firebirds had a couple opportunities early, and Aurora just kind of sprinted down, got their offense set up, and executed perfectly. Get things rolling. Back off the draw. Once again, Higgins with the pickup. Firebirds look to set up their offense. Now it's the Firebirds moving quickly. I believe that's Hannah Kim. Shannon Heichmann working behind the net. Back up to the top of the crease. Claridge. Back over to Higgins. Higgins moving to the right. Spartan offense shifting over. Sticks up in the air, trying to defend the high pass. Castle, moving it around. Here's Claridge, moving to her right. No room for a pass. Kicked inside, deflected away, recovered by the Firebirds. Off the far side, it's Kim. Goes behind the net, tries to set up the offense. There's a shot attempt and a score. Bing, bing. I believe it was Claridge. We'll wait to get confirmation. It appeared Claridge was the one to make the cut in towards the net, receive the pass cleanly and fire up.
And a Carthage goal by number 5, Hannah Kim, assisted by number 8, Kylie Higgins.
And it was indeed Hannah Kim. In the number 5 jersey, a sophomore out of Aurora, Colorado. Different, of course, from the Aurora University out of Illinois. Kim notches her 3rd goal on the year. The assist going to Higgins. Gets possession. It's knocked to the ground, and the clock will stop. Change out of equipment. Kim's last goal came back on March 13th against Concordia. Her other one of the two prior to today was on the road and lost to Colorado College. The offensive attempt fizzles out for the Firebirds. Aurora tries to get out of their own zone. Mishap on the defensive end, catching the ball cleanly. Allowing the Firebirds to put some pressure. Across midfield now. This has been Aurora's tactic so far. Get across midfield and just sprint into the attacking zone. Try and catch the Firebirds slow off that first step. Taylor Jansen, defender, senior out of Menominee Falls. Restart. Over to Russell. Russell to Peck. Get it inside. Shot. Off the mark. Recovered by the Spartans. Sets it back up inside. Pass not fielded. Cleanly recovered by the Firebirds and taken the other way. Over the 30. And across into midfield. Here's Clarish. All alone. 4-on-3 met. Jeff Clarish. Goes behind the net. Nothing doing. Firebirds will take time to set up the offense. Clarish had a quick breakaway opportunity, but the shot was never there. So she wisely held onto it, went behind the net, and reset. Trying to find that smart shot for the Firebirds. Top. Quick move to the right side. Defensive pressure holds firm. Still working from behind the net. Brings it out off to the left side. On defender. Behind the net once more. Defense still holding right at that low point right off the net. Goalkeeper sticking to her right. Clarence weaves through. And that is going to be a shot clock violation on the Firebirds. Aurora will take over. Great defense there for the Spartans. Locking in. Never throughout all that. That whole 90 seconds. Firebirds didn't have a single good look there to even attempt a shot. Skip out of bounds. Firebirds will take over. Moving quickly now. Ball's on the ground. Recovered by the Spartans. Carson trying to keep up the pressure. Keep them inside their own 30. That ball skips over. The defenders recovered by the Spartans. They take it over midfield and get the successful clear. Back of the net they go. Inside middle, wide open pass, shot, score! On that shot, Kenley Axvig again, her second goal of the game.
And an Aurora goal by number 20, Kenley Axvig.
and the Spartans jump back out to a 2-1 lead. 6:56 remaining in the first quarter. That was just a perfectly executed offense there. Axvig coming in off the top, wide open. Just one-on-one with the goalie. Nothing that could be done on that. Up here we are going to have a timeout here. At the 6:56 mark. Firebirds coming in off a 19-0 victory over Milwaukee School of Engineering, or MSOE. Put up 8 goals in the first quarter, followed by 3 in the second, and a total of 8 in the second half. Leading the way in that one, Clarigen Lefevre with 5 each. Kylie Higgins, 4 goals to follow. Then in the win prior to that against Concordia, Wisconsin, it was the Piper Lefevre offensive clinic, tying the program single game record, 9 goals as well as an assist, as the Firebirds took care of business up in Mequon. Claret had 4 goals in that game. Heitschmidt had 3. The goal for Kim and Higgins. Quick look at some of the individual stats here. Obviously, Kim had the goal earlier with the assist going to Higgins. Kim has the only shot recorded for the Firebirds. Heitschmidt, Ruff, and Castle only credited with ground balls so far. Claridge forced a turnover. On the Aurora side, both goals go to Axvig, both assists to Cobbett. Axvig responsible for the only 2 shots taken. Correction, not the only 2 shots taken, one that also was credited to Peck, so 3 shots have been taken by the Spartans. So far it's been that fast, that lightning quick Aurora offensive attack, utilizing transition to their favor and kind of catching the Firebirds off guard with how quickly they move into the attacking zone. Start up once again. Lefevre takes it and immediately sprints into the attacking zone, working on the far right corner. Spins it around to the near side and works back up towards the top of the circle. Clear it with it. Of a circle, weaving in, ball is out and recovered by the goalie Megan Ginty, sophomore out of Wheaton, Illinois, product of Wheaton North High School, and the Spartans will take it the other way. Back to Ginty to set up the offense, swing it around. Once again, very quick move into the attacking zone as they get it down to Russell. Swinging around the horn they go. Back into the corner for Russell. Russell goes inside. pass was intended for Nicolina Smith. Number one jersey batted away and taken over by the Firebirds. Firebirds get across midfield. Get the successful clear as Heitschmidt takes it along the goal line. Back around the horn they go. Claret with it at the top of the attacking zone. She maneuvers the offense around. Pass gets deflected, recovered by Claret. And whistles blow as Spartan hits the ground. Appears to be an injured player on the field. Slow to get up is going to be number 19, Caitlin Cron. Senior out of Loveland, Ohio. There's maybe a penalty on the play as well. Let's take a look. Is going on. They just called it a turnover on Nolan. Not seeing on the stat line at least any cards come out. The Spartans take over possession. Trapped in her own zone. Ball comes out. To the Spartans. Kylie Reeve trying to work through her own zone. And once again, the Spartans get over the midfield line and work in to the attacking zone real quick. As Jansen finds Russell, they work it back around the backside of the net. Spartans been using the same offensive strategy for most of this quarter. Get it behind the net, find someone cutting inside, and there it works again. Another goal for the Spartans. That is going to be number 11, Kaylee Russell.
And an Aurora goal by number 11, Kaylee Russell.
10th goal of the season. To give the assist to Cobbett. So now the Spartans jumping out to a 3-1 lead, 2:42 to go in the first quarter. Carthage had some offensive opportunities, but Aurora's defense has been stifling in their own zone. Firebirds struggling to compete with the quick transition offense that Aurora has been sporting here today. On the draw, covered by Higgins. She enters the Aurora attacking zone. There's going to be a card on the play. Be on number 23, Brianna Peck, junior out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Northwest Academy. So Firebirds winner, their first man-up situation of the game. Get the ball into the attacking zone behind the net. behind the net. Trying to look for that cut. Finds a pass. Not received cleanly. That call will go against the Firebirds. Spartans will take it the other way. So another blown offensive opportunity so far. Appears we are about 7 seconds away from going even. Firebirds squander the advantage opportunity as Aurora will set up their offense with even strength. Reeve at the top of the circle, works on the near side, gets it stripped away. Ground ball still up in the air, still bouncing around. And even though it's recovered by Axvig, gives the Firebirds defense a slight breather, kicking it back out to almost the 40-yard line of the football field markings. Peck sets things up at the top of the circle. Over to Russell on the near side. Russell looking for an open teammate, and the stick hits off the face. We might have a free opportunity here for the Spartans. The stick just caught the face of Kaylee Russell. I believe it was the stick of Taylor Ruff for the Firebirds. Ball skips over on the far corner. Spartans look to reset. That will end the opening quarter. 3-1 our score. Aurora's offense off to a quick start, but the Firebirds hold within two thanks to a goal from Hannah Kim.
At the end of the first period, your score remains Aurora 3, Carthage 1.
Pickups for the Spartans. One save apiece between the two squads. Aurora 7-for-9 in clearing attempts, and that's been the big thing, is Firebirds have had it in the attacking zone. Had it in there for quite a decent amount of time in the first quarter. Just couldn't find the right shots, taking only two out of those 9 clear attempts. Firebirds have cleared twice successfully on 2 attempts. Size 5 turnovers apiece. We're causing 3 of the Firebirds 5, as the Firebirds force just 1 of the Spartans 5. So far on the season, the Firebirds averaging 12.67 goals per game, only allowing 8.67. Spartans scoring 12, allowing 12.57. Offensive-defensive ratio for the Spartans has been pretty level so far. Let's take a look at your screen at the CCIW standings. Carroll leading the way right now at 6-1. Carthage sitting at the 3 spot at 4-2. Just a half game behind the Titans of Illinois Wesleyan and a half game ahead of Chicago. A full game ahead of North Central, Elmhurst, and Augustana round out the conference. Conference play not underway just yet. Play set to begin April 6th. Firebirds host Elmhurst right here at Art Keller Field at 1 p.m. So we get set for quarter number 2, 15 minutes back on the clock. For the draw, Aurora with Axvig out there. Carthage takes it into the attacking zone. Kim on the near side. Sends it back up. Up top to reset the offense. Just under 60 on the shot clock. Ball skips away. Ginty comes up with it, and the ball will go the other way for the Spartans. Not sure what happened there on that. Higgins went to drive in with it. Ball skips out. Ginty comes away with it and resets the possession towards the Spartans. Let's go quickly into the attacking zone. Spartans have been very successful so far using this around-the-horn offense, get the ball behind the net, having someone cut inside for a shot attempt. Work back behind the net. Over to the far corner. Swinging back around the horn once again. Cuts inside. Ball skips out. Recovered. Recovered by Alessandra Almendarez. Carthage goalkeeper. Just one save for her on the day. That means she inches closer to the all-time career saves record at Carthage. Time record being 468 saves. Held by Allie Gorman from 2011 to 2014. Almendarez is just 8 saves away now. Just 8 saves away from tying the record, 9 from claiming it for herself. Kim, top of the key. Claridge cuts inside, has an opportunity, gets tripped up and takes out a defender with her. It's going to stay with the Firebirds. Offensive opportunities. So Claridge got around the defender, had a chance to drive in, just got a little tripped up. be a shot clock violation on the Firebirds. So another good defensive stop there for the Spartans. So they take it the other way. Scrambling around. Clock stoppage here. There's going to be a penalty. Send two now in. So if we get on the play stats here, what the penalty was. Whatever it is, it has Carthage's Emma McDonald off on the sideline in a man-up situation as Almendares comes away with the ball there. Ball was scrambling around in front of the net. Actually, that is going to be a green card on Taylor Ruff. It's going to be the official call. Stats might be a little off there, as it was indeed McDonald that went over to the sideline. 15 and 16. Close back and forth, but back to even strength. The Firebirds go in their own offensive end. Setting up now. Claridge goes inside, loses her footing, loses the ball. Goes the other way, and oh! Marriage hits the ground hard and gets the whistle. Possession back with the Firebirds. Free opportunity here. Clarence fires a shot and scores. Hits the ground in doing so, but goes top shelf and gets the Firebirds a little bit closer in this deficit, 3-2. I believe a yellow card is going to come out here as well. What the call is going to be. Free position goal has been awarded to Claridge. Still waiting to hear on the card. Heading towards the sideline. Yellow card is going to go on Aurora's Kylie Reeve.
And the Carthage goal by number 3, August Reeve.
Claridge notches her first goal of the game, 23rd of the year, taking the team lead from Lefevre. With the yellow card, the Firebird's going to get right back. Kim sprinted out towards the 15. Pass went awry and gets bobbled up. Recovered on the ground ball by Claridge. Kim on that start took off like she was competing for the track and field team. That 40-yard dash time there would have been impressive by NFL standards. She wasted no time and wastes no time again. There's a shot and a goal to even it up at 3. I believe it's Claridge again. Her second goal of the day. It is. Heitschmidt gets the assist. Claridge back-to-back goals to level it up at 3 apiece. Here in the second quarter, 8:39 to go.
And another Carthage goal by number 3,
Just see the aggressiveness on the offensive end there, paying off for the Firebirds. Something we didn't see a lot of in the first quarter. They seemed more passive, trying to work the ball around, find the right shot. This time it started off, Kim just gunned it off the whistle, got in the attacking zone, similar to what we've seen Aurora use offensively. Found Heichman on the... Actually, it was Clarence who found Heichman off the ground ball. Heichman able to get right back to Clarence, who scored. And once again, here goes Kim over the 25, across the 20. And in to McDonald. McDonald working past the back line, gets the screen. And gets over to the far side. Firebirds taking time setting up their offense. It's Heichman behind the net. Moving in. Shot attempt. Ball slips free from Claridge, and it's on the ground. Battling for it and recovering it is the Spartans. They take it the other way, but stripped out right back. Unsuccessful clearing attempt for the Spartans. Firebirds once again look to set up their offense. Take what would be. Take another lead. It would be their first lead of the day. Shot goes wide. And that shot was by Higgins. By Claridge, and there's another shot and another goal. That one's going to be Heichman. After getting a couple of assists so far, she finds the back of the net herself.
And the Carthage goal by number two, Shannon.
Heichman, an assist and a goal on the day. McDonald credited with the assist. Her first of the day. Heichman notches goal number 9 on the year. McDonald, her second assist on the season. And the Firebirds, with 7:15 to go here in the first half, have their first lead of the day. It's 4-3. On the draw. Bouncing around. It's going to be picked up by Hannah Kim. And she takes off to the races again. 40, 30, 25. Finds Claridge. Claridge with the spin move. The shot and the score. And it's a hat trick for August Claridge. Hats off to you. 3 goals in the last... That's within the last 5 minutes for Claridge. Give that... Less than 2.5 minutes for a hat trick. 4 goals in the last 2.5 minutes for the Firebirds. 3 of them going to August Claridge. Unassisted goal there with a beautiful spin move over her right shoulder. Got her footing back, found the open slot, and fired. And quick scoring update for the Firebirds around the nest. Number 10, Firebirds men's volleyball team, ranked 10th in the country, that is, sweeping the number 11 North Central Cardinals 3 straight sets, 25-15, 25-19, 25-21, for a huge win in Tarbell Arena. Firebirds get the season sweep over the rival North Central Cardinals. Big as Kim's off to the races again, across the 20-15. It over to McDonald. McDonald back to Heichman behind the net. Working around the top of the key. Here's Claridge. Heichman now at the top of the circle. Pass bobbled a bit, but recovered by Castle. Bailey Castle, the freshman out of Chesterfield, Mississippi. players is going to be... free position attempt here. On the whistle. Pass inside. Look for Clarence. Missed. And this clock is going to stop again. And I believe another card may be coming here. See what they decide to call. It looks like they're sending number 13, Cassidy Fissner, to the sidelines. See what the official call ends up being, but nonetheless, a man-up opportunity for the Firebirds. Claridge will take it from the top of the inner crest. Claridge fires, scores! 4 goals on the day for August Claridge here in the second quarter. And the Firebirds jumping out to an even bigger lead. 6-3 now. The man up goal for Claridge on the free position shot.
Number 3, August Claridge.
Claridge now up to 26 goals on the season. Quickly solidifying her position as the sole scoring leader for the Firebirds. Firebirds now, after being down 3-1, going on a 5-0 rally. Take a 6-3 lead here with 5:52 to go in the first half. Aurora recovers on the ground ball. Taking it around is Cobbett. Trying to slow things down on their own end. Quick opportunity. Shot deflected away. Aurora keeps possession. Put the ball around. The front blocked by Almendarez. And the defense prevails for the Firebirds. Almendarez from behind the net. Kicks it back to a defender, and the Firebirds look to clear. That's Sophia Winterkorn moving with it now. All on the ground, picked up by McDonald. McDonald behind the net to Heitschmidt. Heitschmidt looking for the cut. Kicks it back up top. Schmidt near the top of the outer crest. Higgins couldn't recover it, but fielded cleanly by Castle. Claridge shot, no good. Skips out of bounds. Possession to the Spartans. Heading into this game, Claridge 6th in the conference in shots per game, averaging 6.67. Goals per game, she and Lefevre were both tied for 3rd at 3.67 in goals per game. Lefevre was just ahead of Claridge in points per game due to those extra assists that we mentioned earlier. Aurora with it back in the attacking end. Right, work through the attacking zone and re-pick up the momentum they had in the first quarter offensively. And oh, mighty shove there sends Cobbett to the ground. We'll see if we get a penalty off of this or just a free position attempt. It appears just a free position attempt is coming. Spartans set it up. Move the ball around. The top of the crest. Now behind the net. Looking for that cut they've been getting early. Pass goes off target. And recovered by the Firebirds. Almendarez. Setting it up. Saves so far for Almendarez in this. He heard just seven away from claiming the all-time saves record for the Firebirds program. Almendarez sixth right now in the conference. Goals against average at 12.86. As the Spartans take it the other way towards Almendarez. And moving quickly into the attacking zone, that's Smith. Ball on the ground, recovered, shot, and a score for the Spartans. And I believe that was Kaylee Russell on the goal. That is Russell's second now, so all four Spartan goals have either come off the stick of Russell or Axvig. With a minute 14 to go in the first half, the Spartans trying to get back into the deficit. 6-4 our score. Set with the draw attempt here in the second. Looking quickly here before we end the half at the history between these two programs. The Firebirds have the all-time series at 5-2. But as of recent history, those two losses were on the last two times these two teams saw each other. Last year's matchup on March 25th of 2023, going the way of the Spartans in a 17-6 finish. Clock winding down here, 35 seconds to go. Castle working it around, finds Kim. Kim inside. Ball kicks around, recovered by Kim. 20 seconds to go. Trying to work it inside. Top of the key, 10 seconds to go. Inside, Clarish, shot, goes wide. It will go the way of the Spartans as time will expire. We hit the half in this one. 6-4, Carthage leads with August Klarich. Four goals. She alone has matched the Spartans' total of the day. She has definitely been the striking force here. Carthage notching five goals in that second quarter. All of those goals coming within a four-minute window. In the second quarter, the first goal came from Claridge at 9:16. They went on a 5-0 run between 9:16 and 5:52 to give a somewhat comfortable lead for the Firebirds. They got a 3-goal cushion as a time. Aurora adds one back to get within two. We'll take a quick breather for the half. Come back, we'll get you the first half stats. And be ready for half number two between the Aurora Spartans and your Carthage Firebirds. Almost back for half number two here at Art Keller Field. 6-4 our score. The Firebirds lead the Spartans of Aurora after an impressive second quarter. 5 goals tallied for the Firebirds. 4 of them coming off the stick of August Claridge, bringing her season total to 26 goals. Look at the stat line here. Aurora got 3 goals in the first, 1 in the second. Carthage the opposite, 1 goal in the first, 5 in the second to jump out to that 6-4 lead. Aurora's goals off the sticks of Kaylee Russell and Kenley Axvig, 2 each. 3 of the assists going to Daniel Cobbett. Fourth goal being unassisted. Firebirds, 4 goals for Claridge, 1 for Shannon Heitschmidt, and 1 for Hannah Kim. Kim getting the lone one in the first quarter. Turnovers evenly matched right now. Carthage 9, Aurora 8. Ground balls even, shots favoring the Firebirds, 11-8. Definitely a big turn from where they were at in the first period. Aurora at the end of the first had led 4-2. Firebirds out shooting the Spartans 9-4 in the second. As time on halftime expires, the teams getting ready to take the field. You're just joining us. 6-4 our score. Carthage in white with red numbers. Aurora in blue, also with white numbers. On the individual stat line, the other mark to watch for right now. Alessandra Almendarez. 3 saves in this game. Just 7 away from claiming the all-time Carthage career saves record. Firebirds looking to keep that offense from the second period going. Maybe get Piper Lefevre involved a bit more too today. Busy on the draws. From there, it has not been a big part of the offense. Comes the draw there, finds Kim. Kim, once again, sprinting to the races. Firebirds set up their offense. Going behind the net. Thank you. starts working it around. Shot clock under 50. Sun coming up. Or going down, I should say. Off to the west on the far side. Shadow's starting to make seeing numbers on the far side a little tricky. Clarish at the top of the crest. Kicks it inside. Beautiful pass. Shot. Deflects wide. Carthage will retain possession. That shot is going to be credited to Heichmann, and it went high. Be a shot clock violation against the Firebirds. Aurora takes over. 13:15 to go in the third. Carthage not putting on a lot of pressure on the defensive end. Now the pressure meets up around the Spartans 40. Aurora trying to get across midfield, get the clear. Good defensive pressure. Kim meets at the 30. Behind the net they go. Cobbett looking for the cut. Up top to Peck. Trying to work inside. Finds Peck again. Kicked over to Cobbett. Cobbett can't receive it cleanly. We'll pick it up and have to reset. 29 on the shot clock. Pass to Peck, ball gets out, loose, recovered. By Almendarez and taken the other way. Good defensive stop there for the Firebirds. And a successful clear into their own zone. Kicked over to Clarish. Clarish moves inside, takes the shot. Saved by Ginty. Ginty tries to clear it. Sails over the head of the Spartan. And recovered around midfield by the Spartans. And now it's the Spartans' turn to go off to the races. Across the 20, across the 15, dumps inside. Ball not handled cleanly on the pass by Peck, and it's going the other way for the Firebirds. Firebirds successfully get across midfield. Off to the races they go. 40, 30. Slowed up and resets. Clarence with the ball. Gets it over to Kim. Kim on the far side. Working it around is Bailey Castle. Castle back at the top of the crest. Finds Higgins. Offensive motion. Higgins over to Kim. Kim underneath behind the net. Opportunity wasted. Under 30 on the shot clock. Higgins looking for an open teammate. Finds Kim. Kim off the far side. Dishes it behind the net. Swings it around near side. Finds Clarish. Clarish. Shot and a score. Make it 5 on the day for August Clarish. And the Firebirds jump out to a 7-4 lead.
And the Carthage goal by number 3, August Clarish, assisted by number 15, Emma McDonald.
McDonald credited on the assist. And now 5 goals for August Clarish in this one. McDonald, 2 assists. What an offensive day it has been for August Klarich. Seems like almost every attempt she has taken, she has found the back of the net. With four shots on goal, she's got four goals, eight shots total. And Kim, once again, off to the races. Carthage working behind the net. Now Klarich on the near side. Klarich, a freshman out of Wheaton, Illinois. Wheaton, Warrenville South. Wheaton, Warrenville South High School. Far on the season, has scored in every game. One more score and she would set a season and a career high. She's scored five goals in two separate outings so far against MSOE and St. Mary's. Another goal will have to wait as the Spartans take over offensively. Spartans still working to try and clear it out of their own zone. Good defensive pressure so far by the front line of Firebirds. We're going to get a foul. I believe a card here, green card against Heitschmidt. Got a little too aggressive with the stick. Spartans will now be in a man-up situation. For a minute. Mackenzie Wilson with the ball now, without the ball. Picks up loose ball and sent the other way. Kicked out of bounds. Referee says it stays with the Spartans. Wilson, freshman midfielder, Newport Richey, Florida. Working their way inside. This is Kylie Reeve, and a whistle blows. I believe we are going to get a free position attempt. They called it against Cindy Kuyeva on the Firebirds. It's a free position attempt, just leads to a reset for the offense for the Spartans. Working inside, kicked along the goal line, back up top. Working inside now, back to the goal line again, and a stoppage of play. Just another free position attempt there. This time it goes against Sophia Winterkorn. Once again, just a reset of the offense. Under 25 to go on the shot clock, though. Aurora's got to get something rolling here. Pass inside. Knocked away. Spartans recover, 12 seconds on the shot clock. Kicked inside, open opportunity. Shot goes high. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Aurora trying to get something off. And the shot clock will sound. Some good defense there by the Firebirds. Aurora only getting one shot attempt off during that time. It went high. Not resetting the shot clock, and the Firebirds take over. 6:24 to go in the third quarter. 7-4, our score in favor of the Firebirds. Carthage, actually both teams for that matter, looking for their third consecutive win. Firebirds Firebirds working on the far side. As Kim kicks it over towards the corner. Kicked over. Heitschmidt's shot goes wide. Firebirds retain possession. 25 to go on the shot clock. Under 10 seconds to go now. 5, 3. And it looks like it's going to be another shot clock violation for the Firebirds. So back-to-back possessions between the two squads have ended with the shot clock sounding. It's become a strong defensive quarter so far on both sides. Just one goal in this quarter, and oof. Spartan hits the ground. That's going to be Mackenzie Wilson. Hit the ground hard in transition. Appears to be all right and able to keep playing. Spartans retain possession. Starts the play, but she heads immediately towards the bench. It doesn't appear that they were ready to make a substitution there. Must be some sort of injury. She needs to be taken care of, as now Allie Pope comes in. Appears we have another stoppage of the clock here. And whatever the foul was, it's going to be on the Spartans, so the Firebirds will take over. That was called on Cobbett. .340 to go in the third quarter. This game so far has been breezing by. I believe we've only had one timeout called. That was by Carthage back in the first period. On top of that, no, hardly any clock stoppages in this quarter. Just one goal so far. There's a clock stoppage right there. As I believe it was Higgins hit the ground and got the call. She'll have a free position attempt, courtesy of Caitlin Cron. Out of bounds, stays with the Firebirds. They reset. And oh, another hard hit near the goal. Different players a little slow to get up there. Possession will go to the Spartans. This foul is called on Claridge. Ginty gets it out. And here comes Aurora off to the races again across the 40, the 30, into a successful clear. That was Kylie Reeve. Full sprint over a good chunk of the field to successfully clear it for the Spartans, and now they reset with their offense. Moving to the far side of the net. Kicked inside, pass deflected away, shot! And I believe that's a goal for Aurora. Let's see if I can figure out who scored it here before the stats tell us. I believe they're going to credit it to number 11, Kaylee Russell. That That will be Russell's hat trick on the day. It was indeed credited to Russell, so Russell, the second player on the day on either side to have a hat trick. Russell now up to 12 goals on the year, just 9 coming in, 4th highest on this Spartan roster. 2:10 to go in the third, the Spartans close back within 2 goals. Not a whole lot going on offensively in this quarter, but the Spartans will get possession off the draw. The pass sails high over the head of Russell. Firebirds take over despite losing the opening draw. Skips away. Covered by Taylor Jansen. Now they reset with Russell. To the top of the crest with Peck. And she gets it right back to Russell. Russell back to Peck. Good save there on the high pass. Here's Russell inside to Peck. Peck gets hit hard and goes down. I believe that is going to be Piper Lefevre called for the penalty. I believe it's going to be a 2-minute yellow card against Piper Lefevre. That was a very hard hit on Peck. Peck's going to have the free position opportunity here. Chance to get the Spartans back within 1 goal. Off the whistle. She drives inside. And defended well. Clock stops. And they're going to call a push and give another free position attempt to Peck. It was Kim on the push. As Peck hit the ground right at the feet of Almendarez before being able to get a shot off. Attempting again. Shoots. Scores. Spartans get back within a goal. Peck. Brianna Peck, the junior out of Vegas. Increases her season scoring lead with her 22nd goal on the season. And that free position attempt, she got up close where she needed to be. And found the open slot around Almendarez to bring the Spartans back within 1 of tying this game. After giving up 5 unanswered goals in the second quarter. There's now 2 back-to-back goals for the Spartans, keeping them within striking distance. Been full of momentum shifts throughout. A lot of the goals coming on the north end of the field. At this point of the game, 10 of the 13 goals scored combined between the squads have come on this north side, which Aurora is attacking at in this quarter. You figure if that trend sticks, bodes well for the Firebirds heading into the fourth quarter. They can just hold out for the next minute until the end of the third. Spartans trying to even it up before they have to flip over towards the south side. Pack rolling inside, dips it out behind the net. Flipped inside. Shot! Score! And the Spartans tie it up here near the end of the third. And once again, Kaylee Russell, her fourth goal. She's trying to keep up with Claridge. And with 15 seconds left to go in the third, the Aurora Spartans have evened the score at 7 apiece.
And an Aurora goal for number 11, Kaylee Russell.
Russell now, fourth goal on the day, 13th on the year. She is now just one goal away from tying Cobbett for the third most goals on the team this season. She has been able to finally open slots around Almendarez in the same way that Claridge has been able to find the back of the net against Ginty. I believe a timeout was called by Carthage, their second timeout called of the game. First of the quarter. Seven goals on 13 shots. Firebirds, seven goals on 16 shots. Almendarez has notched five saves so far. Ginty, just one save. Both teams with 12 turnovers. Aurora leading the ground ball count, 19-18. The clearing attempt average goes by the way of the Firebirds, 10 of 11. Aurora just 15 of 18 as we reset here, tied at 7. 15 seconds to go in the third. Ball skips away and picked up by Jansen. Jansen tries to hustle down the field, get one more shot attempt before time runs out. A kick behind the net. Down. The period will end before Aurora can get an open look, but the damage was done in the third. Aurora going on a 3-1 run to open the second half. We will head to the fourth, tied at 7 here from Art Keller Field.
Thank you.
back here for the start of the fourth period at Art Keller Field. We've got a tie ball game, 7-7 our score between Aurora and Carthage. Carthage had a 6-4 lead heading into the second half. Aurora went on a 3-0 run to close out the third quarter to level it at 7-all. Carthage save for Almendarez. That's five now, just five away from the all-time record. Ball kicks the other way. A stoppage of clock from the official farthest away. Not sure what the cause was, maybe just a substitution. Aurora takes it the other way. Moving quickly into the attacking zone. Finds the open look, shoots. And a whistle blows. And I believe it's a goal for Aurora. Not sure what the delay in the call was. Sure, even who got the final shot off. They're going to give it to Axvig, so Axvig gets the hat trick, joining Russell as the third player to put on a hat today. Three goals for Axvig. Axvig now up to 22 on the season, tying Peck for the lead. So, four unanswered goals for the Spartans. Give them back the lead. 13:41 to go. And another hard hit there. Card issued. I believe they got issued to Heitschmidt. It's going to be a green card, so just 1 minute. But nonetheless, a man-up opportunity for the Spartans here with a one-goal lead. The Spartans got the momentum back late in the third quarter. And now with another opportunity to add a insurance goal. A shot and a goal, there it is. The insurance goal. Insurance goal for number five, Kylie Reeve. Man up goal is going to add 9-7 on the scoreboard. 13:03 to go on the clock in the fourth quarter. Reeve gets her first goal of the game. Her fourth goal on the season. Reeve, a junior out of California. And just like that, the pendulum swings. Five answered goals, unanswered goals now for the Spartans. The Firebirds scrambling for an opportunity to cut down the deficit once again. Second time they've seen a two-goal deficit today. First coming back in the first quarter at the 2:42 mark when the Spartans took a 3-1 lead. Firebirds used 5 unanswered goals of their own to jump out 6-3. But this second half has been all Spartans on the offensive end. Since the all within the last 4-5 minutes of playtime, Firebirds notched a goal 5 minutes into the third quarter. Since then, momentum has been with the Spartans. Firebirds get the ground ball. 30 seconds on the shot clock. Kim has trouble receiving it, picks it up. Gets it over to Heichmann. Heichmann takes it behind the net. Looks for the cut, doesn't find an opening. Down to 10 on the shot clock. Gotta get a shot off here. Inside, ball bouncing around. And the horn sounds, a shot clock violation. Costly mistake there for the Firebirds as it goes the other way. 11-18, that's a valuable 90 seconds. The Firebirds could not use to their advantage. Spartans now working behind the net. And taking some time off the clock here. No reason to rush with a 2-goal lead. Clock is their friend at this point. Burn 90 seconds down. Get it under the 10-minute mark. Under 40 on the shot clock. Spartans begin to move. All of a sudden the offense comes alive here. Buzzing around the net like a bunch of bees. Ball deflected away. And another stoppage of clock as a Spartan is down on the ground. Slow to get up, that's Taylor Jansen, the senior. Hit the ground in that scramble. Jansen now back on her feet and will head to the bench. Appears to be holding her mouth. Near her mouth, at least, trying to see. She might have gotten hit around the mouth-face region. Hopefully she'll be all right and be able to return to the game at some point. Shot clock resets at 90. Not what the Firebirds needed out of that. 10-10 to go. Free position attempt here. Quick jump by Kim. She's sent out of the inner crest. Aurora elects to just reset the offense, work the clock some more. This right, they can get it to about 8:40 before the shot clock wears down. Ball on the ground, recovered by the Spartans. 59 on the shot. Aurora works it underneath. Kicked back out top. The cut inside, and there's another goal for the Spartans. 6 unanswered now for Aurora. That is going to be Peck.
And a goal for Aurora by number 23, Brianna Peck.
Brianna Peck scores another one to take back lead on the scoring chart on the season for the Spartans. Now at 23 on the year. And not what you want to see if you're the Carthage Firebirds right now, is if Carthage will take a timeout as head coach Rebecca Conjul wants to talk things over, try and re-rally the troops after six unanswered goals. Have the Spartans with a three-goal advantage, 9:22 to go in the fourth. Looking ahead for Aurora after they finish up this game with the Firebirds. We'll have two games at home against Hope College, whose men's team we just saw earlier this afternoon as they took on and defeated Carthage men's lacrosse squad. That game will be between the Spartans and the Dutch on Wednesday, March 27th at Spartan Athletic Park. Then on Saturday the 30th, the Spartans will host the Calvin Knights at 1 p.m. They'll begin conference play themselves as well on April 6th against Concordia, Wisconsin to start NAC play. Meanwhile, the Firebirds, as I already mentioned, they'll host Elmhurst on April 6th to open CCIW play. Before that, we will see on Tuesday, the 26th, the Firebirds return to Art Keller Field to take on Lake Forest before hosting Wisconsin Lacrosse on the 30th at 1 p.m. right here at Art Keller. Out of the timeout, 9:22 to go. The Firebirds desperate for some offense here in the second half. Now been outscored in the second half 6-1. Struggling for answers. Referee sorting things out on the opening draw. Take possession. Getting across into the attacking zone. At this point, Aurora can start really milking the clock. Working time down. Get under the 7:30 mark before Carthage can even touch the ball again if they want to. Behind the net, 45 seconds to go on the shot clock. And back up top. Around the horn they go. Now moving the cut inside. Pass deflected away. Out of bounds. Aurora keeps possession, 20 on the shot clock. Kick back inside with the cut. Ball bounces around in front of the net. The mad scramble. It's going to be the Firebirds who come away with it. I think that's Hannah Kim. Correction, that was Higgins. Now here's Kim. Across the 40. Whistle blows. Firebirds keep possession. Inside to McDonald. Behind the net for Heitschman. It's the best opportunity the Firebirds have seen offensively in a little while. Spent a lot of time on the defensive end this quarter. Spartans have done a really good job of keeping the offense limited pretty much to Claridge in this game. So there, Heitschmidt loses the ball, and it goes into the net of Ginty's stick. Spartans take it back the other way, get it across midfield. All skips ahead, ground ball pick up for the Spartans. Defensive pressure. The ball is once again on the ground. Whistle blows, and it's going to be Spartans' ball. 6:05 to go in the quarter. The net they go, and we've seen this offensive strategy all game long for them. Work the ball around, get behind the net, find somebody to make that cut for an open look at the net. Firebirds take over possession for a lost ball by the Spartans. Strong effort there to get it into the attacking zone for Carthage. Ball comes on the far side. Moving inside quickly. Open look. Shot goes high. Shot for Claridge. Possession stays with the Firebirds. Firebirds offense gone stagnant for the last 25 minutes. Last goal came around the 9-minute mark of the third quarter. Body hits the ground, no whistle. Play on. That's the inside. Claridge gets absolutely hammered around the 6-yard line. Had an open look and just ran into a brick wall. Free position attempt coming for the Firebirds. Claridge has already scored once on one today. She rushes inside, fires. Shot goes high. Possession stays with the Firebirds. Another shot clock violation for the Firebirds. Had a good look there off the shot from Claridge, but couldn't recover in time before time expired. Spartans take it the other way. Under 4 minutes to go. So they're starting to look bleak as more bodies hit the ground around the midfield mark. Fissner sent to the sideline for a minute. Carthage possession. Kicked on the near side. Unable to be received cleanly by Winterkorn. She picks up the error and gets it inside to Kim. Kim had a good opportunity for a spin move, didn't realize it. Kicks inside to McDonald. McDonald inside and a goal. McDonald on the assist. I believe that's Claridge again. Correction, that is Heitschmidt on the goal. McDonald with a beautiful feed to the inside for a one-on-one look for Heitschmidt.
Shannon Heitschmidt, assisted by number 15, Emma McDonald.
Heitschmidt's second goal of the day 10th goal on the season. And with 3:10 to go, the Firebirds back within two. Not out of this one yet. On the draw, Carthage gets it cleanly. Quick run inside. It's Higgins. Inside to Heitschmidt, has to force it back out to McDonald. McDonald behind the net. Finds the cut. Shot. Score! Back within one! The Firebirds offense is back alive and the crowd along with it. It's going to be Higgins on the goal. Assist coming from Claridge. And that was a beautiful cut by Higgins. Well read by Claridge and a perfect pass. Well timed. Ginty had no time to react, and just like that, the Firebirds back within one. 2:49 to go, back-to-back goals within 21 seconds of each other. And it appears that Aurora head coach Christina Fried is going to take a timeout and try and regroup. What a momentum swing for the Firebirds. They seemed dead in the water. No goals coming between 9:55 in the third quarter to the 3:10 mark of the fourth quarter. You figure that is almost, I'm not good at mental math. I'm going to have to figure this one out. The old trusty Apple calculator here. That's 22 minutes without a goal. So I'm going to go from nearly 22 minutes without a goal to two goals in 22 seconds to get the momentum right back on your side. 2:49 to go. And Higgins gets them within one with an assist coming from Claridge. Higgins' first goal of the game. Ninth goal on the season. And just like that, this game got interesting again. Here with 2:49 to go. See if the timeout pays off for Aurora. Cut the momentum and regain composure. Since the start, this crowd has gotten electric. Some of the crowd probably joining us late, following the Firebirds' victory in Tarble Arena for men's volleyball. The ball skips out. Kim on the ground ball. Gets past the defender. Inside the 20. Inside for Heitschmidt. Shot blocked away. Ground ball pickup by Heitschmidt. 2:21 to go. Firebirds resetting the offense. Heitschmidt behind the net. Looks inside. Kicks back out. It's a good move. Claridge trying to find a shot. Has nothing. Ball skips out. And a whistle blows. It's going to be a free position attempt for Claridge. Great positioning for the season-leading score for the Firebirds. Whistle blows. Shot. Score! Birds tie it up! August Claridge with her sixth goal of the game, and the freshman has a new season and career high. And with a minute 36 to go, the Firebirds even it up at 10. What a battle back and forth this has been all game long. Claridge on the free position. Didn't didn't even bother getting close on that one. She took about four steps and fired. Both teams with three goals here in the fourth and 96 seconds to try and take a lead. I'm amazed neither side takes a timeout here to think things over. Whistle blows. The Fever wins the draw. She's been one they've kept quiet offensively tonight, but Clarence, they haven't been able to stop. A minute 20 to go. Ball skips past Kim. She's able to hit it, not in time though. And Aurora will take over possession. 70 seconds to go. Ball skips away. McDonald forces the turnover. Heitschmidt with it. Inside. Shoots. And a nice save there by Ginty. Keeping the game tied. 52 seconds to go. Aurora on a full sprint across the field. Across the 40. 30. This is Peck. Kicked off the left side. 40 seconds to go. I believe it's going to be a timeout for Aurora. They want to set up a play. 37.7 to go on the clock in a tied 10-10 ball game. What a finish we are headed towards here at Art Keller Field. Aurora jumped out to a 3-1 lead in the first. Carthage answering back with five unanswered goals to jump out to a 6-3 lead. Aurora added one more to make it 6-4 before the half. And Aurora came out all out swinging in the third quarter after giving up the first goal in the second half to Carthage. They went six unanswered goals to jump out to a 10-7 lead. And then the Firebirds woke up in the final 3 minutes and 10 seconds. 3:10, the goal from Heitschmidt. 2:49, the goal from Higgins. And at 1:36, the tying goal from Claridge on a free position shot. Now with 37.7 to go, the Spartans have a shot to hang on and win it. So they will have the ball. No timeouts left for the Spartans. One remaining for Carthage. So far this season, in games decided, games decided by less than three goals, the Spartans are 2-2. Firebirds have not had a game this close yet. Clock is running. 35 seconds to go. Aurora behind the net. This is the offense that's worked for them all night long. Back to the top. Swings back around on the near side. Behind the net. Looking for the cut. Can't find it. Kick to the other side. Looking for the near side cut. And back to the top. Carthage running the zone. 10 seconds to go. Inside. Shot. Knocked away. 5 seconds to go. They're scrambling around for the ground ball. It's knocked away by Almendares. And the end of regulation. 10-10 our score. We will have 6 minutes to go. Wow, what a finish we are headed towards here.
Going into overtime, your score, 6, Carthage, 10, Aurora, 10.
It appears it will be a 5-minute runoff here.
What's up, fellas? Hey,
Ref signaling for the runoff to start has not started yet. There will be a 5-minute break. And when we come back, overtime between Aurora and Carthage in what has been a roller coaster of momentum. Back here at Art Keller Field, and we are almost set for overtime here between Carthage and Aurora as these two women's lacrosse teams have battled it out. And if you're just joining in, you have missed a wild ride. 10-10 our score, and the momentum has swung in the most dramatic ways possible. Both teams seeing 5 unanswered goals at one point. 6 for the Firebirds. Actually, both had 6. Looking at the stats, correcting myself. 6 unanswered goals on each side as the pendulum has swung back and forth. Right now, Carthage working on a 3 unanswered goal run. Maybe a quick breakdown of overtime rules. There will be a 3-minute period between the squads. If no one scores, they will have another 3-minute period and flip sides. Sudden death, first goal wins. It is for all the marbles. Find the back of the net, you go home happy. The This game was one that seemed all but wrapped up for Aurora. About 4 minutes to go. They had a 10-7 lead. And really, for over 20 minutes, the Firebirds could not get any offense going in the second half. The offense finally woke up with 3 minutes to go, notching three goals in just over 90 seconds. Interesting to see, win or lose, what Coach Congel has to say about this game afterwards. Here we go, overtime underway. Both teams with one timeout each in the period. Whistle blows. Ball kicks up. Higgins recovers. And initially, the referee signaled Carthage ball, switched it to Aurora. The crowd not happy. And quickly there, ball don't lie. Firebirds strip it away. That's Heitschmidt off to the races across the 30. He gets it inside the 10, takes it towards her typical position behind the net. Kicking around the backside. Carthage is now taking time to set it up. Higgins at the top of the circle. Kim gets it back behind the net to Heitschmidt. Heitschmidt. Inside. Shot! Goal! Let's go home! The Firebirds walk it off in overtime! With four unanswered goals! In just over 4 minutes of play! Between... four goals in just over 4 minutes after being down 10-7 with four to play. The Firebirds come away with it in overtime. And who else to score the game winner but August Claridge? Claridge, her seventh goal of the day. Have a day, August. Needless to say, I think we know who the player of the game would be if we were to give out a daily player of the game award. But August Claridge came to play today and is the hero for the Firebirds. For a quick look at her line, 7 goals, 1 assist, 8 points on 13 shots, 7 on goal, 4 ground balls, and 1 cause turnover. An incredible game for the freshman, an incredible game for the Firebirds. What a show of resilience. Again, seemed down in the water with 4 minutes to go. And came back to swing the momentum fully the other way. And we are going to take it down towards the scoreboard as the teams will be ready to ring the bell. And what a phenomenal way to ring the bell. Let's take it down to the field. What a well-deserved ringing of the victory bell that was for the Firebirds women's lacrosse team. 11-10 in overtime, overcoming a 10-7 deficit. And what a game it was, back and forth, entertaining the entire way. Momentum swinging both ways. Aurora fought hard to the end. Both teams looking for that third consecutive win. And the Firebirds prevail at home in front of the home crowd on a chilly Saturday afternoon. August Clarence once again, 7 goals, a new career high, leading the way. Heitschmidt, 2 goals, 2 assists. Higgins notching a goal and an assist. McDonald with 3 assists. Alessandra Almendarez, 5 saves. So she'll still be looking for that all-time program record as we head into the next outing, which again will be on Tuesday against Lake Forest right here at Art Keller Field. And if you're Coach Congel, Coach Harrison, Coach Ramel, you got to be thrilled with the fight that this Firebirds team showed today. This was an incredible outing, an incredible performance all the way around. You know, there were definitely times where the offense struggled. There's times where the defense couldn't keep up with the offensive pressure. But every time it seemed like the Firebirds couldn't quite come back, they proved everyone wrong and rallied together, scoring goals. And it wasn't just Heitschmidt either. With Heitschmidt and Klarich, the team, just every time somebody got an open look, they weren't afraid to make the pass, make the shot, and the team really came together late in this game to rally and get the win. That's going to do it for our broadcast today. Special thank you to our executive producer, Mike Love, our producer, John Voinovich, our director, Allison, graphics replay, Laura, Sarah, and Addison, and the rest of our incredible team here at Carthage College. You've been watching a Firebird Broadcast Productions. This program has been a presentation of Carthage College, copyright 2024. Once again, the Firebirds take an 11-10 victory here in overtime at Art Keller Field. We thank you for watching. This is Justin Corrigan saying so long.